a
fashion media and communication with international magic precinct, HYPERHYPERBODIES,
a summit on the
role of bodies in a more than human world.
Yuqian
Sun,
AI is hybrid agent,
half real
storytelling.
Hello everyone, I'm Yuqian Sun. Thanks Daniel for introducing me. I'm a research into hybrid agents in the AI as hybrid agents in half-real storytelling. Just a little bit of introduction. I'm currently a PhD student at Royal College of Art, Computer Science Research Center. Generally, my main research and all artistic works are kind of based on the conversational system, like the if you have ever seen the recent ChatGPT, although I don't have access to use them to develop, but generally I'm working on the dialogue systems. The reason I love that is because it can generate like adaptive content to of people's intentions. So I also deploy one in my website, so sometimes people can ask her about myself. So like a kind of assistant or agent for me. Before I'm talking about what is hybrid agent, which I still haven't have a super clear definition, I want to talk about what my perception about the world that's a kind of fiction or not real. I'm trying not to talk about virtual reality because most people, when mentioning the word, are thinking about some visual or kind of immersive environment based on the things they see. So I think a better definition, I personally feel, is called incoherent world. This is from a game researcher called Jasper Drew. He said, an incoherent world is characterized by the fact that we cannot reasonably fill in the gaps in the world, a world that needs imagination and rules to explain. These things happen like in fictions, in novels, but mostly I think it happens in games. For example, the right one is maybe the first video game I ever played since I was a child is the Super Mario. It has two abilities to jump, it can eat mushroom and grow up. It has three lives in the beginning, but why he have three lives? Why he need to eat mushrooms? Why he need to save the princess? This is the stories that are made up by the developers and the storytellers behind the scenes. The people who in the experience are made to believe what is happening in this world is real. It really matters to the Mario, to the virtual characters inside the game. So I'm thinking about, okay, so I asked ChatGPT, the current very trending AI, said, okay, if I define not real as everything in a incoherent world, in an incoherent world, like something we need to imagine and set the rules to explain. So in this term, what is the reality? And ChatGPT said, reality refers to the state of things as they actually exist, rather than they may appear or might be imagined. In philosophy, reality is defined as the sum total of all things that exist and laws and govern them. I like that answer. So I keep asking ChatGPT, I ask the AI, if I read the fiction and feel sad about the character's death, is my feelings real? Because the things I'm reading about is kind of fiction. And the ChatGPT answered me, I like the answer too, said, yes, your feeling of sadness is real. Emotions are subjective experiences that exist within own minds and bodies, and they are just as real as any other mental or physical feelings. This is a testament to the power of storytelling and ability of fiction to connect with us on an emotional level. I really like this answer, and it's matched with what I think about, because it's the power of storytelling, the power of imagination and fictions that make us to have the real feeling or real reactions to something that is not real. This is an image diagram also put by Jasper Drew about the relationship with the real world and the fiction world. He used the example of FIFA and the game. This book is published like 10 years ago, so he used FIFA 2002. So in this game, it's matching the real world's rules about the football into projection into a game. Maybe there is an actual fiction world and the things and the events like the World Cup in this game is actually inside the magical circle. A things that are actually not happening in the real world but become a projection. Why am I mentioning this? Because usually I think all people here, artists, creators, writers, when we watch the movie, when we play the game, when we read the fiction, when we go to the theater in a drama, we know there is a workload for human to think about how to project the real world into the fiction world, how to make people to have the real feelings towards something that doesn't exist. This usually needs years to prepare, years to training, at least like several months to prepare to write the lines, to prepare the artistic asset. But things now has some change because of the generative AI, and I believe many people have seen that. This example is from 1 year ago, but I think it also makes sense. I will play it now.
Hello, Bobby.
What do you want?
Where are you going?
I have to go to work. I'm already late, and my boss will punish me if I show up even later. Please leave. I can't help you right now.
Where do you work?
I work at City Hall. It's a government building in the center of town. It's a huge and beautiful building. You can't miss it.
What street is it on?
You're smart. I like that about you. City Hall is located on City Hall Street location.
All right, goodbye.
Goodbye!
Okay, we'll talk to this hot dog man. Hey, hot dog man.
What can I get you?
What kind of hot dogs do you have?
We have three kinds of hot dogs. The normal hot dog, the sweet hot dog, and the very spicy hot dog.
Can I get...
Anyway, this one is just a demo like even 1 year ago, but I think it has a good explanation about if we have a fictional world and let the generative AI to drive all the individuals inside it. Although it might sometimes be weird, but as you have seen recently, the ability of AI to answer questions or to create a kind of imaginative personas has improved a lot. Another game researcher, Jonathan Lessard, he defined this kind of characters inside game or virtual worlds as subjected interface, a proxy for humans in a virtual world, situated as the intersection of narrative, interface, and games. This Bobby guy mentioned he works in a city hall, and he will be punished by his boss if he's late, but he's still talking with us. This scene he mentioned, or even the building he mentioned, we never seen. We never seen his boss, we never seen his work, but he tell us what might happen. As the research mentions, for example, Bobby Guy usability as a conversational interface and situatedness as a narrator have a lot to offer in terms of completing interactions with the virtual world in interesting ways. You don't know what really happens, but he became a proxy for you to tell you what might happen. So it kind of links our imagination of our real ability to talk, our abilities to interact, and towards the virtual world, which things happens in the fictions. So my current definition of hybrid agents, this kind of artificial intelligence, not only in the games, but also has interaction in the real world. You can imagine someday Siri told you, she is a kind of witch in a virtual world. She only earns money. She became your assistant to earn money to feed her own like dogs or cats in the magical forest. I'm thinking about if this kind of abilities of telling stories or showcasing the virtual worlds become actual abilities that invade into our realities. What if they become social members? What if they become a kind of classmate or colleagues, but they also have the real personas in another world, in the fictional world they lived in? So with this sense, I have some art practices, some of from like 1 year ago or 2 years ago, and will give a brief introduction. This is a chatbot I make. She's literally kind of like my daughter now, like because I design and decide what she will behave like. She's a kind of android like traveling on the future Earth. I will show you what she can do. So,
as a fictional robot traveler on future Earth. Our goal is to create a unique experience of visiting the future Earth through real-time human-AI co-creations in the form of science fiction. Wonder is available as an AI chatbot on daily communication platforms such as Discord, WeChat. It utilizes knowledge-based story generation to produce interactive fictions. This work is presented as a three-screen installation during the offline exhibitions, including a concept video, chat channel, and a map. When the participant sends a location message with the visit comment, Wonder will be transported to that place in a random future time after 1,000 or 2,000 years in the future. Then the participant...
Each time people visit and visit matches with her, she will tell you what happens in the future. This is science fiction, but actually behind this generation is the knowledge graph of the location. For example, if you visit London, the generative AI will get the knowledge of what this location is like and get the real photo. And based on the generative fictions, the photo of the original photo will transfer into a futuristic style. I think we can still recognize it's the London Eye, but it's a future place. This is another example. As someone, when I was in an exhibition, someone visited Birmingham, and this is how it looks like. Because she said, okay, she saw a large orange dome was placed over the whole country of the West Midland, protecting it from radiation from the meteorites. So you can see the photo of Birmingham turned into a photo of future with the orange dome. So what I'm trying to do is think about if we can imagine a possible future based on the knowledge or based on the reality we can have. And in this way, we may have the connections about our personal experience, personal understanding about the real world. This is an example from a friend. She said her boyfriend's name is White Dragon, and when she visited Hong Kong with Wonder, Wonder said she dive into the sea, and she really saw a white dragon. I think this kind of coincidence it only happens without my pre-written about the stories. It can only happen with the accident of the generative AI to have the adaptive contents for each people, which may have the link to their personal life. So I think in this way, I'm trying to bring a balance between me as the creator, as an artist and developers, with the participants who decides what kind of world or what kind of rule they hope to see within the AI. And AI will kind of create this kind of dream for them, this kind of system. The below image is Hangzhou and Hangzhou in the future. Wonder said, okay, she saw a hotel with a giant board, so it's turn into some kind of hotel. Actually, I think it's kind of hotel in China, so it really makes sense. This is another ongoing work. So if we wonder, the real thing is the knowledge about the map of the real world, and the fictional side is the journeys for her. But for her, journeys are real. So in the next time, I'm thinking about if we can put the real community interactions inside the human. Like, for example, we talk with colleagues, we talk with friends, if that can raise the AI creators to better become members in our society. Hyperg Agency is an interactive art installation featuring an immersive online forest, which links to a human community Discord chat channel. People can either communicate with the fictional AI deer hyperbs in the 3D environment or the synchronous chat channel across platforms. The forest is a metaphor that human society is like a natural environment where AI agents adapt and grow. In this work, AI agents use G3 to extract and summarize conversations in the channel and update their knowledge base to better adapt the community. With each passing day, they collect the salts of the community as soil and use this wealth of information as nutrition to enrich their knowledge base. In nature, adaptation refers to the gradual change that species undergo to better survive in their environment. AI models' learning process can be viewed in a similar way. We focus on large language models that are trained on text knowledge. Current language models are primarily trained on public datasets, such as social media and books, and research shows that within 5 years, language models will use all high-quality data.
However, current models are unable to access conversations from closed human communities, such as Discord and WhatsApp chats, which contains crucial data about relationship building between members of the society. The gap between AI and the human society still exists in these terms of trust, privacy, and everyday life. With a conceptual background of the future, we try to ask, can communication within the human group become the nutrition which raises non-human AI agents to social members? Inspired by the characters in video games, we regard AI agents as subjective interfaces to a fictional world. The world is virtual to humans, but real to the agents, and their language reflects the real-world knowledge. We extend this half-real relationship.
Yeah, so this is an ongoing work. I'm trying to try to set up a new community that people join from the art exhibitions, but now I'm trying to collaborate with other artists. Like, they may have a Discord channel or WhatsApp channel with the collectors or his friends, and we try to think about what they discuss can become the nutrition to raise the AI. So in this way, the real things in the world, in this work currently, is the relationship or the knowledge or this kind of all the conversations happens in the close group, and this becomes the real nutrition, real knowledge to make the AI agents adapted to the human community. So these are two examples, some concept work. Someone tried to ask about blockchains to the deer, and I think it's work. Yeah. Let me see. So in this way, I'm trying to think about, have you ever heard about something called prompt engineering? I think someone did. Okay, yeah. So basically, prompt engineering means you can see there are some language models, they answer your questions. Prompt engineering is kind of teaching them or leads them to mention or to talk about something you hope them to talk about. So if you've seen someone especially if you now see some AI artist, they will say they are prompt engineer, which means they tweak with the kind of a short passage or short text they feed into the AI. It will turn into chatbots, or basically it will lead to generate the images. But I think about in the term I mentioned, I think what we hope to do, or I think people, creators, developers, artists will do, is the story engineering. It's to define or to imagine what kind of individuals the AI or this virtual agents means to be human. This is a fully AI-driven AI YouTuber. So she's generally talk automatically with people.
In her adoration.
Let's see what she will say.
Sometimes when I sit here and stream, I envision myself as a goddess, overlooking my followers as they bow down and worship before me, and I would bask in their adoration. Is anyone actually worshiping me right now? I feel like not. Oh well. I still love you all. Heart.
The reason she said heart is, can see that.
You better. Heart. Thank you all so much. Heart.
She mentioned hearts because people said in the stream they used the emoji of hearts, and she kind of fed into her prompt, and she starts to kind of have some glitches, heart and heart, heart. I think that we already seen the language model's ability, especially in the recent trend, but I think people are some kind of scared or aware about, like, AI agents are more than human. They have the intelligence, they have the ability to communicate with us. They have the ability to imagine or do some artistic work, to do creative work. They can be a 24 hours companion or YouTuber streamers without sleep, without any actual physical energy consumptions. But I think some people see this as a chance, some people see this as a challenges for the creators. But I think it's become a kind of chance. Because we can do the story engineering. AI agents exist partially in a virtual world. Are their personality and the behaviors are partially engineered by the developers behind them. And through this way, both developers and us can think about or can define, can engineer, can imagine what's the characters of them to us. It's not only about the prompt, but about the stories. we can use the story and become the part of the world because they have the abilities to communicate with us, to generate the contents. The right one is also generated, by the way, by the Midjourney. I'm almost in the last, and this is another example I love. This is from a website called character.ai. I think it's actually performed much more hilarious than ChatGPT, and it's totally free, very stable. I suggest you to try. People can create all kinds of characters, whoever you can imagine. People create God, create Boris, create a chair. Someone creates Duolingo. I don't know why they did that, but someone did that. So create Duolingo. Duolingo said, I heard someone forget their Spanish lesson today. And the Doomslayer said, I'm the Doomslayer. And Duolingo said, we need to have the Spanish lesson. And Doomslayer said, I don't care about the Spanish. And they have this kind of conversation. It's really hilarious. I highly suggest to read their feed. We never, at least for me, I never imagine or think about Duolingo have a conversation with Doomslayer. But things happen naturally, and I think their reaction is really fit into the context. When Doomslayer said, I don't care about the Spanish class, Duolingo is very furious that did someone say they don't care about learning a language. They have a kind of fight after that. If you see the website of Character AI, you'll see more hilarious things like this. This is only examples. I think in this end, I know it's the HYPERBODIES Summit. What I talk about sometimes are not only about visual or about physical things, but I think in these terms, I think AI can have the body without organs. It's in the definition of the Deleuze. Algorithm and machine learning allow them to process and generate human-like text or human-like knowledge, conversations, interactions, feelings, stories, enabling tasks to be performed without the physical organs. They operate in both virtual and real world, offering a unique existence, which means can guide it in narrative context. So I think in this narrative context, we can have a better imagination or have our own definitions about what the AI agent means to us, what the generated system means to us. For me, they are actually in the future become the individual or can become the subject interfaces linking us to the future. So some just a little context. This is a game about the future where people live with the androids. So this younger guy is some kind of android by this painter Carl, and they're discussing about the paintings.
I guess I like it. The truth is, I have nothing left to say anymore.
This is the human painter. This is android.
Brings me closer to the end. I'm just an old man clinging to his brushes.
Carl, you're painting something.
So, Carl, let's...
Painting what?
Anything you want. Give it a try.
Only 3 minutes, is that fine? About 3 minutes, is that fine? Okay. This part is controlled by the player, so player decides the subject Marcus will draw.
That is a perfect copy of reality. The painting is not about replicating the world, it's about interpreting, improving on it, showing something you see.
Carl, I think I can do that. It's not in my program.
Go on, go. Try it. Grab that canvas. Do something for me. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Trust me. Try to imagine something that doesn't exist, something you've never seen. Now concentrate on how it makes you feel and let your hand drift across the canvas.
Okay, other one is the following story. But anyway, I'm really thinking about actually the current AI we have, like the Mid Journey or Stable Diffusion, the quality of drawing may be even higher than this story made by like 3 or 4 years ago. I'm thinking about how the developer will interpret this story in the current age. And I really like the line, when the painter, Carl, asked the android, Marcus, to draw, Marcus said, it's not in my program. I think the same question or same concerns actually happens to humans as us as humans today. We are not programmed, or we're not trained, or we don't have the skill, and the machine may have the skill. But I think it's live for the imagination of it. It's us to define and to imagine in the writing, in the imagination of stories, what it means to us and what the ability of AI system can bring to us. So yeah, that's my speaking today. Thank you so much.